Recently, a video clip from Sean P. Diddy Combs' acceptance speech at the Academy's Salute to Industry Icons Award in 2020 has gone viral across social media. In this speech, Diddy spoke with authority about the power and influence of the hip-hop community, saying, "We control what's cool. We control what's hot. We control what your kids listen to, what they dance to. We control everything." These words reflect a central theme prevalent in Hollywood and hip-hop: pride. As Christians, we must examine the implications of pride, both in our personal lives and in the broader cultural context.
We have the power. We decide what's hot. If we don't go, nobody goes. If we don't support, nobody supports. We control what's cool. We control what's hot. We control what your kids listen to, what they dance to. We control what's in video games. We control how they wear their pants, sag their pants. We control everything.
Before we focus on how prideful this clip is, let us focus on Hollywood. The central theme of the last days is deception. This is why Jesus, in Matthew 24, time and time again warned us, his children, about deception. Scripture repeatedly warns that deception will characterize the end times, targeting both believers and unbelievers. Deception is indeed a hallmark of the last days. Hollywood is one of the greatest tools of deception, particularly when viewed through a biblical lens. It has an unparalleled influence on shaping global worldviews and values. Through music, movies, and entertainment, it often promotes ideologies that oppose God. And here, in this clip, we see the mindset of someone who, at the time, was one of the most powerful men in Hollywood, boldly claiming, "We control everything." This statement reveals a dangerous illusion of control, a hallmark of pride, and a worldview detached from the sovereignty of God. But it also begs deeper questions. Why is it that the vast majority of what comes out of Hollywood is negative? Why is everything so godless? Why is the majority of Hollywood content hypersexualized? These questions are not accidental. They point to a deliberate agenda. Hollywood is not merely a source of entertainment. It is a powerful force of influence that shapes the thoughts, beliefs, and behaviors of billions around the world. It operates as a cultural engine, dictating what is deemed normal or acceptable, and redefining morality for the masses. Ask yourself, why do we now live in a world that calls good evil and evil good? Why is biblical truth mocked while sin is celebrated? Hollywood has mastered the art of reprogramming minds, subtly and overtly reshaping societal norms to align with values that contradict God's word. Through the constant bombardment of godless and often blasphemous content, it conditions people to reject biblical principles and embrace a worldview centered on self, pleasure, and rebellion. The hypersexuality in Hollywood is a prime example of this reprogramming. Modern films, TV shows, and even music videos are saturated with sexual imagery and narratives that glorify promiscuity and immorality. What was once considered shameful or taboo is now accepted and celebrated. The entertainment industry normalizes behaviors that Scripture warns against, making them seem harmless or even desirable. This is no accident. It is a calculated effort to erode the moral fabric of society and desensitize people to sin. People are becoming more and more desensitized to sin. The whole world is becoming more and more desensitized to sin. By portraying sin as glamorous and consequence-free, Hollywood deceives millions into believing that there is no need for accountability. The world is being reprogrammed. And in the clip we have just seen, we witness one of the world's most famous entertainers at the time blatantly and proudly declare that they are the ones in control. Furthermore, Hollywood's influence extends beyond individuals to entire societies, creating a collective mindset that values fame, fortune, and power above all else. The industry glorifies materialism and self-exaltation, presenting these as the ultimate goals in life. Celebrities are idols, and their lifestyles, often characterized by excess and debauchery, are held up as ideals to aspire to. Hollywood's messaging also aligns with the broader agenda of the god of this world, Satan, who seeks to blind the minds of unbelievers. Consider how often Hollywood glamorizes the occult and witchcraft. From children's movies to blockbuster franchises, themes of magic, sorcery, and spiritual powers are presented as harmless or even heroic. This normalization of the occult desensitizes audiences to practices that the Bible explicitly condemns. It subtly shifts people's perspectives, making them more open to spiritual deception and less discerning of the truth. At its core, Hollywood reflects the spiritual battle described in Ephesians 6:12. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. The content it produces is not random or neutral. It serves a purpose in the larger spiritual war for the hearts and minds of humanity. By distracting people from God and normalizing sin, Hollywood plays a key role in advancing the agenda of darkness. The mindset displayed in this viral clip, "We control everything," is not just an expression of pride, but also a reflection of the deception that Hollywood propagates. This belief in human control and self-sufficiency directly opposes the biblical truth that God alone is sovereign. Pride is a self-exalting attitude that disregards God's authority and elevates human self-sufficiency. Hollywood and hip-hop often glorify this mindset. Celebrities live in a world of luxury, surrounded by affirmation from fans and yes men and yes women who feed their egos. Red carpets, private jets, designer clothes, and multi-million dollar homes encourages a culture that celebrates human greatness while neglecting humility and dependence on God. For ordinary people who struggle with pride, the temptations are amplified for those in the spotlight. Celebrities are often surrounded by yes men and yes women who never challenge their actions, who tell them how great they are, who stroke their egos and feed their pride. This environment creates an illusion of control and invincibility, an illusion that contradicts the reality of God's sovereignty. Proverbs 6:16-17 lists pride as the first of six things that the Lord hates. These six things the Lord hates. Yes, seven are an abomination to him: a proud look, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood. The prominence of a proud look in this list reveals the gravity of pride in God's eyes. Pride is not a new issue. It is the sin that caused Lucifer to be cast out of heaven. Isaiah 14, verses 12 to 15 describes Lucifer's fall. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. Yet thou shalt be brought down to hell, to the sides of the pit. Lucifer's desire to elevate himself above God illustrates the destructive nature of pride. In the same way, the pride displayed in Diddy's speech.
We have the power. We decide what's hot. If we don't go, nobody goes. If we don't support, nobody supports. We control what's cool. We control what's hot. We control what your kids listen to, what they dance to. We control what's in video games. We control how they wear their pants, sag their pants. We control everything.
The assertion that we control everything mirrors the attitude that led to Lucifer's downfall. The truth is, none of us are in control. God is. The illusion of control is a hallmark of pride. Celebrities and moguls may believe that their wealth and influence place them in command of their lives, but Scripture reminds us that God holds ultimate authority. James 4, verses 13 to 15 warns against the arrogance of self-sufficiency. Come now, you who say, today or tomorrow we will go to such and such a city, spend a year there, buy and sell and make a profit, whereas you do not know what will happen tomorrow. For what is your life? It is even a vapor that appears for a little time and then vanishes away. Instead, you ought to say, if the Lord wills, we shall live and do this or that. No amount of money, fame, or influence can change the fact that God is in control of every heartbeat and every breath. To live in pride is to live in a lie. The Bible repeatedly warns about the consequences of pride. Proverbs 16:18 states, "Pride goes before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall." The downfall of nations, leaders, and individuals often begins with the seed of pride. History and Scripture offer countless examples of those who exalted themselves, only to be humbled by God's sovereign hand. Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, serves as a powerful illustration. In Daniel 4, Nebuchadnezzar's pride in his kingdom led to his humiliation as God stripped him of his power and sanity until he acknowledged the Most High as ruler over all. This same lesson applies today. The pursuit of self-exaltation, whether through wealth, influence, or fame, is a fragile endeavor. Jesus offers a better way. Matthew 23:12. Whoever exalts himself will be humbled, and whoever humbles himself will be exalted. Humility is not weakness, but strength under God's authority. It is the recognition that every blessing, talent, and opportunity comes from Him, and it is only by His grace that we live and move. Pride blinds us to the truth of our dependence on God, while humility opens the door to His grace. James 4:6 declares, God resists the proud but gives grace to the humble. To resist pride is to align with God's will, living with the understanding that we are stewards of His blessings, not owners. Instead of seeking control, let us surrender to the One who truly holds all power, trusting His plans over our own. The call to humility is a call to freedom. It liberates us from the exhausting pursuit of self-glory and places us in the peace of God's sovereign care. True joy and fulfillment are found not in exalting ourselves, but in exalting Him who alone is worthy of all praise. Let us remember that it is God who raises up and brings down, and in humility find our rightful place as His servants. As Christians, we must be aware of the spiritual enemies we face and the avenues they use to influence our lives. 2 Corinthians 11:14-15 warns us that Satan himself masquerades as an angel of light. It is not surprising, then, if his servants also masquerade as servants of righteousness. Satan often works subtly, using culture, media, and entertainment to normalize sinful behavior and promote rebellion against God. Hollywood and hip-hop are two industries that frequently spread godless values. From the glorification of wealth and power to the normalization of sexual immorality and rebellion, these industries align with the agenda of the God of this world who blinds the minds of unbelievers. The world we live in has a clear agenda to draw people away from God and into sin. Hollywood and hip-hop often serve as tools in this agenda, promoting messages that contradict biblical principles. Consider the prevalence of occult symbolism in music videos, the celebration of greed and materialism, and the encouragement of rebellion against authority. These messages are not accidental. They are part of a larger effort to blind people to the truth of the gospel. The answer lies in the spiritual battle for the human heart and mind. The Bible makes it clear that the world is under the influence of Satan, who is described as the god of this world, 2 Corinthians 4:4. Satan's primary strategy is to entice people away from God by appealing to the desires of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. Films and music provide powerful mediums for this strategy because they appeal directly to human emotions and desires, often bypassing logical thinking and spiritual discernment. Promiscuity, for example, is heavily promoted because it feeds into humanity's fallen nature. It celebrates the fleeting pleasures of the flesh while ignoring the long-term consequences: broken relationships, emotional emptiness, and separation from God. Movies and TV shows often depict promiscuous behavior as glamorous, normal, or even empowering, subtly redefining morality for their audiences. The normalization of sin desensitizes viewers and listeners, making it easier for them to accept these behaviors in their own lives. Music holds a unique power to influence thoughts and emotions. It can bypass rational barriers and embed messages directly into the subconscious mind. This is why music is so often used to glorify sin and rebellion. Modern music frequently celebrates themes of sexual immorality, drug use, violence, and greed. Lyrics that glorify living for the moment or chasing the bag encourage listeners to prioritize their desires over God's will. Even more alarming is the overt glorification of Satan in some music today. Songs, album covers, and performances openly feature satanic imagery and themes. Artists wear pentagrams, reference occult practices, and even explicitly declare allegiance to the devil. This trend is not simply artistic expression, it reflects a deeper spiritual reality. Satan desires worship, and by glorifying him through music, artists and listeners unknowingly participate in his rebellion against God. At its core, the entertainment industry reflects the spiritual battle described in Ephesians 6:12. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. The content promoted by Hollywood and the music industry is not random or coincidental. It serves a purpose. It distracts people from God, numbs their conscience, and encourages them to embrace sin as normal or desirable. Satan uses these tools to create a cult. As Christians, we must be vigilant and discerning about the media we consume. Romans 12:2 instructs us, "Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God." This means being intentional about what we watch, listen to, and support. We must ask ourselves whether the media we consume aligns with God's word or subtly draws us away from Him. As Joshua 24:15 says, "Choose for yourselves this day whom you will serve. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord." Christians must make a conscious decision to reject the values of the world and align their lives with God's word. Pride has serious consequences, both spiritually and practically. Proverbs 16:18 warns, "Pride goes before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall." This verse reminds us that pride leads to downfall. It blinds people to their weaknesses, making them vulnerable to sin and failure. In the case of celebrities, pride often manifests in moral failures, broken relationships, and ultimately spiritual emptiness. The pursuit of fame and fortune can never satisfy the deep longing for God that exists in every human heart. Ecclesiastes 1:2 captures this truth. Meaningless, meaningless, says the teacher. Utterly meaningless, everything is meaningless. Apart from God, even the greatest achievements and possessions are empty. The antidote to pride is humility. James 4:6 tells us, God resists the proud but gives grace to the humble. Humility acknowledges God's sovereignty and our dependence on Him. It involves recognizing our limitations and submitting to God's authority. Jesus modeled humility in His life and ministry. Philippians 2:5-8 says, in your relationships with one another, have the same mindset as Christ Jesus, who, being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be used to His own advantage. Rather, He made Himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man, He humbled Himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. If the Son of God could humble Himself in obedience to the Father, how much more should we? The viral clip of P. Diddy's speech is a reminder of the pride that permeates our culture. Hollywood and hip-hop often glorify self-exaltation and independence from God, but as Christians, we are called to a different standard. Pride is a sin that God hates, and it leads to destruction. By embracing humility and submitting to God's authority, we can resist the influence of the world and live in alignment with His will. Let us take to heart the words of Micah 6:8. He has shown you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God. May we walk humbly with God, rejecting the pride of the world and embracing the grace and truth found in Jesus Christ.